Welcome to Unit 4.3. After having extensively discussed glide planes and crystals in the last two units, we now want to approach the last remaining symmetry element, screw axes. First, we will look at some interesting objects for illustration. Screw axes are, as glide planes, symmetry elements which require two combined respective symmetry operations carried out consecutively. We will see that screw axes are the symmetry elements which describes helical symmetry. This means objects that have the form of a helix, which is only the Greek word for screw or turn. Of course, we can find helical objects in many different areas, not only in crystals. For instance, in architecture. Here we see a beautiful picture of a spiral staircase. Interestingly, as a short side note, the English language is a bit sloppy in this case. A spiral is an object with a gradually changing diameter, while a helix has a constant diameter. This means it should rather be called a helical staircase. In contrast, for instance, pigtails or such climbers, we see here a young sprout of a vine plant, have indeed spiral structures with gradually changing diameters. Objects with helical structure are also widespread in technology, for example, as shown here, a coil spring. And screws have, of course, helical symmetry as well. Helices can also be intertwined, and the most prominent example is, of course, the most important molecule of life, the beautiful DNA, which is a twofold intertwined helix, a double helix. This motif was also used for one of the objects of the famous Danish-Icelandic artist Olafur Eliasson, known for his sculptures and large-scale installation art. Here we see an endless double spiral staircase, and you can walk upwards here and again downwards, climbing up again, and so on. This is an installation in front of an office building in Munich. I am really fascinated by his work, and I can recommend to have a look at Eliasson's webpage. So, what are the characteristics of a helix? Well, first of all, there is the helix or screw axis in the center of a helix. The helix turns around this axis, and any tangent line of any point of the helix makes a constant angle with this fixed line. Furthermore, the pitch of a helix is the length of one complete helix turn, measured parallel to the axis of the helix. And a helix has a so-called handedness. It can be either left or right-handed. With a viewing direction along the axis of the helix, if a clockwise screwing motion moves the helix away from the observer, then it is called a right-handed helix, and inversely. Left and right-handed helices behave like image and mirror image, meaning that helices belong to so-called chiral objects. And this handedness of chiral objects is a property of the helix, not of the viewing direction. A right-handed helix cannot be turned to look like a left-handed one unless it is viewed in a mirror, and vice versa. If you allow, a final remark on helices. A helix, in a strict sense, is something continuous, like here. So the handrail of this staircase is a genuine helix. However, the single steps that build the staircase are of course discrete, so they only build a genuine helix if we draw an imaginary curved line between these steps. And as crystals are composed of discrete atoms, you can imagine that helices in crystals are composed of discrete units. This has, of course, an impact on the rotational symmetry part of this combined symmetry operation. The respective symmetry operation of this symmetry element is called a screw rotation. And this is a combined symmetry operation in which you have to carry out two operations consecutively. First, a rotation around this axis, and then a translation parallel to this axis. If you look at a genuine helix, then you will easily infer that the rotational part can be an arbitrary angle. But in crystals, the rotational part, likewise as discussed for the pure rotations, is again limited. A, because it is composed of concrete entities, and B, because there's this special thing that rotational symmetry in crystals is restricted to the order 1 to 4 and 6. This will be further elucidated in chapter 5. In the next unit, we will dive more deeply into screw axes in crystal structures.